you so much, John, for being here. Can you tell everyone your full name and how do you help clients?
Absolutely. My name is John D. Saunders. You can call me John for sure. You can call me John D., whatever you prefer. And I am a web designer, developer, and brand strategist. So I help clients and startups mostly develop a web presence using web design and development in Webflow.
Excellent. Now, I heard about you, it's funny, not from Clubhouse. I was going to go to this new platform called Podia. And okay. I saw that you were listed on there. Then I'm like, well, maybe he's on Clubhouse. So, and you were, which is like amazing. So yes. My question is, what do you like most about Clubhouse?
I think the biggest thing for me on Clubhouse, and you know, I admit I haven't been on there in a while, was just the authenticity and kind of like the real-time response you got. It was great because you're able to collaborate and talk to people that you normally, under normal circumstances, wouldn't be able to, right? And so I think what Clubhouse did is it bridged the gap between folks all around the nation being able to communicate in real time. Since we couldn't meet in person, it was easier to do through Clubhouse and create and foster those relationships.
True. Now on your bio, it said that you built a 7-figure web design agency. How did you go about doing that?
It's a lot of patience, a lot of ups, a lot of downs. Ultimately, some of the biggest things that helped me were, one, developing a process in the agency and really almost duplicating myself and our proprietary system. So what that means is, when I started the agency, it was just me. You know, we were doing everything. One, the first thing we did was we niched down and we said, okay, we're not going to do all these other services. We're just going to do branding, web design, and development. That's it. And what that did is that made it so that we could create and develop a process to be able to delegate to other team members. So not only did I make step-by-step directions on how we onboarded clients, how we dealt with wireframes and design and research, we itemized that into a process. And then I started to hire individuals to help me do that and perform those tasks. So it helped us scale our efforts and helped us do bigger projects. And also, when you own it and really niche down, you're able to charge a premium because you're great at what you do, right? You do one thing and you do that one thing really, really well. So startups will come to us and they know exactly what they need. They're willing to pay and we're going to give them an awesome product because of the systems that we've created that mitigate issues in the agency. A lot of agencies have an issue where they're building for clients, but they're kind of like going on a whim. Us, everything runs through a step-by-step system. It's regimented and it helps us deal with that flow.
Awesome. Now, you also developed something called Black Illustrations. How did you come up with that idea?
As a web designer and developer, we were creating websites on the norm, and we work with a lot of business owners and startups featuring owners or CEOs, people of color, and Black individuals as well. And so we wanted to show diversity in that content. So we went to sites like Shutterstock and these stock photo sites. We couldn't really find illustrations that spoke to our community, right? A lot of the images and illustrations, the hair, the body type, a lot of these things weren't right. If you did find a person of color, they were like purple with like yellow hair. It just didn't hit home. So I was like, you know what? I haven't seen anything that's really filled the gap here. We're going to go ahead and create it ourselves. So that's when we launched blackillustrations.com. We launched our first pack and we made a pack of 80 plus illustrations completely free, because I figured to make and really help the market and help people develop these ideas and get these illustrations out, we have to make that first batch absolutely free. And it took off. We've seen our illustrations on websites like the CDC, Google. We've seen people use them in their presentations on their website. And now we have more than 3,000 illustrations on our website and we're releasing new packs every week.
Awesome. Yeah, I went on, I was just so happy just to see it. It's very, very
That's awesome.
Now, you also started something called Urban Wallet. What is that?
Yeah, Urban Wallet is a financial literacy platform for urban millennials, where we showcase and discuss financial literacy and generational wealth building properties. So things like, what's an IRA and 401k? What's the difference? What's an APR and a credit card? How to purchase your first home? So just financial literacy fundamentals that were not necessarily taught in school, but that are really systematized and simplified for anyone to be able to follow and execute on.
Excellent. Now, you said you haven't been on Clubhouse in a little while, but when you do go on, how do you go about generating leads from being on the app?
The thing for me, and I'm not really a really great sales guy, I'll be honest, you know, I'm kind of introverted, kind of to myself. But one thing that I do really well is transparent in the way that I show my work and I show what I'm working on. So for me, it's about how much value can I add and how much value can I provide to the web design or branding or design community. So when I go on Clubhouse, I go in with the idea that, hey, I'm going to add value. And hopefully people can see that value and they'll want to connect later on, because that's the biggest thing that I've seen. It's not like just saying, oh yeah, I've done this great thing, I've done this great thing, I've done this great thing. It's more so, hey, here's how I developed a system in my business. Here's a worksheet you can download on how to follow the step-by-step process to get it done in your business. Because anybody can say, oh, I went $1 million. That's great, but how'd you do it? Yeah. You know, and having that breakdown, what it does is it creates brand advocacy. One, people follow you, people want to know you, people want to get with you because they see that you're doing great things. And they also respect you because they feel like you're providing them with value that can help them in their business.
So very true. So what piece of advice would you give somebody who is just starting on Clubhouse and they want to make an impact? What's one piece of advice you could give them?
I would say if they have a community or if they know anyone outside of Clubhouse, just ask, you know, what people want to know, what they're looking for, how can you help? And then based on those questions, start to answer those questions via Clubhouse rooms. So maybe think about, okay, I'll do a room on, you know, branding, how to create a brand guideline, and walk them through the steps while you're on Clubhouse. One other point of advice is while you're doing that Clubhouse, create like a bit.ly link or some type of link that takes them off of the Clubhouse platform so you can convert them to a lead. Maybe they download your document, maybe they get access to your document. That way, you know, you're building your following on Clubhouse, which is amazing, but you're also building a repository of emails and contacts that you can hit up later.
Excellent. Now, I know that there are a lot of web designers. Do you think if someone's trying to come into this space that it's already too crowded, or is there room for more designers?
Oh, there's absolutely room, because folks have to think that you can be a web designer, but you can also niche down as a designer. Like us, we work mostly with startups, and that's pretty much our primary client. So not only does that give us a USP or a unique selling proposition, we're able to go to startups and say, hey, we only deal with you, your type of clients. So we know exactly how to, the language to use. We know exactly how to target your ideal consumer. We know exactly how to figure out your branding so it's modern and tech-centric. And so we really know how to own in on that specific niche. So another web designer that comes in, maybe they're a great chef or they work locally with service-based businesses. They can focus on that as their niche. The only thing you don't want to do is pigeonhole yourself where you're like, we only work with X, right? What you want to do is kind of start broad, see where your passion lies, and then start to niche down from there where you're becoming an expert at that specific niche and field. And then you can always go to those clients and access.
Now, how do you go about finding these startups, or do they find you somehow?
Yeah, it's, you know, for me, it's really creating value-based content and having the clients come to us. We've been lucky to, well, I don't know if I'd say luck, but I've been very consistent for the past 6 years in creating content. Sometimes my content does great. Sometimes it's a straight flop, right? But that content that's a flop, one person might see that piece of content and tell their friend about you. Now they're following you for 3 months. Now when they're ready to start, you know, work on their startup or they're developing their company, who are they going to think of? If I've been consistently providing them with content that they've been able to execute on for 6 months, a year and a half, I'm literally building an advocacy of hundreds of people that are my branding army that are going out and yelling from the rooftops how great our work is and how transparent we are. And that's worked really well for us. You know, 80% of our clients are referrals. We don't really do a lot of outreach. And currently we're pretty much booked up. So it really helps to create that consistent content. The issue that people have is they'll do it for 3 or 4 or 5 6 months. They'll be like, I'm not getting the traction I want. I'm going to give up. When it really comes down to, there's one specific moment that can literally turn your life around where maybe you're a year and a half in, you create one piece of content, and that one piece of content creates a ton of leads.
Very true. I totally agree. Yeah. Content is key. Where can people find you online, John, if they want to learn more about you?
Oh yeah, I'm on. So my biggest platform is probably Instagram. You can find me John D. Saunders on Instagram. You can check out my website, johndsaunders.co. And you can check out Black Illustrations at blackillustrations.com.
Awesome. Thank you so much for being with us, John. And we'll see you
in
Clubhouse.
No worries. Thank you.